Monitoring for the recurrence of DCIS typically involves mammograms if breast conservation has been done. Diagnosing in situ breast cancer in the first place is typically done because there is an area of suspicious looking microcalcifications in the breast, which I've explained on other videos is a byproduct of calcium precipitating out in the ductal system as the cells lining the ducts overgrow and then die in the center. So the most typical way that DCIS, ductal carcinoma of the breast, is originally diagnosed is with mammograms. Now, can DCIS be associated with a mass and not have microcalcifications? You bet. The answer is yes. In fact, I just had a patient in her early 70s this past week that's exactly the way her DCIS was diagnosed. DCIS can present as a mass. And the more fatty replaced the breast is, the easier it is to see such masses. So the overriding question now is, in dense breasts, how do we monitor for the recurrence of DCIS? Well, fundamental after breast conservation is clearly digital mammograms. If the mammograms are stable, they're typically done once a year. A lot of interesting data is coming out of Europe about using MRI as not only a way of diagnosing DCIS in the first place, but also then monitoring it, the breast for the recurrence of DCIS. Unfortunately, that data has not really taken hold here in the U.S., but has certainly taken hold in places like Germany. And we'll be fascinated here to follow their reports as they keep progressing. There's also been a recent report at a big national radiology meeting in November of 2011 from the University of Washington in Seattle, again about using MRI as a way of monitoring patients for recurrent cancer after the treatment of both invasive and DCIS. And their data, quite frankly, was positive in that they diagnosed the recurrence earlier and more effectively. Now, that sort of small study is going to have to be replicated at other sites, certainly here in the United States, before MRI becomes a standard component of monitoring the recurrence of DCIS in densely breasted patients. Also on the horizon is a molecular imaging of the breast. There are studies going on at the Mayo Clinic using this technology. More will be revealed as we know about it here at Breast Cancer Answers in the future about the role of molecular imaging as another method of detecting DCIS in the densely breasted patients. But in the meantime, keep getting those digital mammograms. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.